Being on sick leave can sometimes be necessary, but at the same time, it's also a risk factor for a range of negative side effects, such as unemployment and increased disability. Luckily, there are some things that can be done to prevent these negative consequences of sick leave. A systematic review published in the Cochrane Library in 2015 shows that workplace interventions can reduce the time it takes for a worker with musculoskeletal pain to return to work compared with usual care. Furthermore, optimizing the workplace management of employees on sick leave is associated with a reduction in pain and an increase in functional status. While the review does not specify what a workplace can do to optimize return to work, here are some suggestions. 1. Ensure that the worker is an active part of the solution from the beginning and possibly involved in the rehabilitation prior to the first day of returning to work. 2. Let the worker and the supervisor rank the obstacles for returning to work in a formalized way, such as a company policy. 3. Make an action plan for returning to work that allows for fast track or partial return to work, even when it means making temporary adjustments to equipment, the workstation, or the workflow. 4. Make it possible for all stakeholders to meet and to facilitate early work-based interventions. 5. Provide relevant assessment to rule out serious pathology. 6. Provide education about how to manage pain and how to gradually return to work. 7. Prevent conflicting advice by coordinating the management plan between all stakeholders. 8. Unless pain is expected to vanish within a week, focus on return to work, not on pain reduction. If you want to know more about work-related pain, check out Prevent for Work on Facebook and YouTube.